Research suggests that the VO2 Max test is one of the best ways to test all-cause mortality. Hello everyone, I am Dr. Donald Ozello of Championship Chiropractic in Las Vegas, Nevada. Welcome to today's episode of Dr. Ozello Sports Medicine Report. The VO2 Max test is traditionally performed at a medical facility, but recently, researchers at the University of Kent State in Ohio have formulated a way to perform this test at home. Yes, there is a self-test for the VO2 Max. Now, please remember, this is a test for people who are advanced athletes. Do not perform this test on your own. Always have someone watching you and observing you to make sure that you are doing okay. You want to be as safe as possible. Yes, this is the disclaimer part of the video. I'm putting this in the very beginning of the video. So be careful when you are doing this test. This test is for advanced athletes who are already training. Please check with a medical professional before performing this test. You want to make sure that you are doing it correctly and you want to make sure that you are healthy enough to perform this test. If you start to feel any type of symptoms while performing the VO2 Max self-test, please stop immediately. These symptoms could include lightheadedness, dizziness, shortness of breath, heart palpitations, just overall not feeling well, feeling as if you are pushing yourself too hard. So please go ahead and stop because this is an intense test. You want to be as safe as possible. You are testing for your overall health. So do not perform this test if this test is too much for you or too intense for you. The VO2 Max test is one of the most challenging fitness tests. Research suggests that the VO2 Max test is one of the best ways to test all-cause mortality. The VO2 Max test is typically an intense 10 to 20 minute treadmill run where you push your body to maintain the highest intensity. It is a challenging test and a solid indicator of cardiovascular health. The maximum oxygen output, known as VO2 Max, reflects the ability of the person to absorb, transport, and utilize oxygen. This defines a person's functional aerobic capacity. This capacity is the gold standard of cardiorespiratory fitness. Maximum VO2 is the measure of one's aerobic capacity, representing the amount of oxygen taken in by the skeletal muscles during exercise. This is a linear relationship between exercise intensity and oxygen uptake until the cardiovascular system can no longer meet the demands of the exercising muscles. This is known as oxygen uptake plateau and is achieved following progressive exercise. Higher VO2 levels represent greater aerobic fitness. Males have higher peak VO2 due to increased hemoglobin levels, increased stroke volume, and greater muscle mass. Declines in VO2 max happen with age. There is approximately a 10% decrease every 10 years after 30 years of age. This is due to decreases in stroke volume and maximal heart rate. Pathophysiological states can impair VO2 max, as seen in heart failure or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is often abbreviated to COPD, and in general deconditioning. Scores below 80% of predicted values based on age, gender, and atherometric data are considered abnormal. VO2 max less than 80% of predicted values represents reduced aerobic capacity suggested of cardiopulmonary or metabolic impairments. A low VO2 max, despite normal cardiovascular, pulmonary, and metabolic parameters, is suggestive of deconditioning. Research suggests that VO2 max indicates mortality better than risk factors such as cholesterol, BMI, and blood glucose. One study found that people with a stronger VO2 max, which is the top one-third of those tested, had a 45% reduced risk for all-cause mortality compared to those with the worst scores, which is the bottom third of those tested. The reason is simple. VO2 Max is possibly the best test for measuring endurance and strength of the cardiovascular system. Sophisticated equipment is usually needed to perform a VO2 Max test. Recently, researchers at Kent State University in Ohio developed an accurate way to perform a self VO2 Max test. It takes around 10 to 12 minutes and is a useful tool to assess your fitness level and provide a baseline to increase fitness. The following equipment is needed for the VO2 Max self-test. You can use a treadmill or exercise bike, a heart rate monitor, a training partner or friend for data collection and to monitor you for any symptoms, and the numbers chart that I have listed in the description box below. And please remember, this is a high intensity test, so you should only undertake it if you are in good health and are already exercising on a regular basis. Always have another person with you while performing the self-test, and always check with a medical professional to make sure that your heart and lungs and musculoskeletal systems are strong enough to perform this test. To perform the test, you want to make sure that you warm up thoroughly. Make sure that your muscles are warmed up and that your body is ready for the test. When the warm-up is complete, set the treadmill to a 1% incline or set the exercise bike to a very light resistance. Following the rate of perceived exertion values that I have listed below, you want to exercise for 2 minutes at a very light level. Then you want to advance in intensity for another 2 minutes. Then the next 2 minutes should be intense, and then another 2 minutes where it is very intense. And as the test continues, you will be working harder to try to honestly gauge your rate of perceived exertion on a moment-to-moment basis, adjusting the speed at any point to stay at the correct effort level. The final 2 minute stage should be an all-out effort. When it begins, increase the speed so that you are running or pedaling as fast as you possibly can. The lead researcher at Kent State University stated, "This will cause fatigue very quickly and you will probably slow down early on. You may even finish the test at walking speed, which is fine." Again, there are five levels. The first 2 minutes are light, and then minutes 2 through 4 are somewhat intense. Minutes 4 through 6 are intense. Minutes 6 through 8 are very intense. And then minutes 8 through 10 are maximum intensity. Before you begin your warm-up, you want to take your resting heart rate. So take your pulse at rest for 60 seconds. This is your resting heart rate. Record your resting heart rate or have your training partner record your resting heart rate. You want to monitor your heart rate throughout the self-test. The maximum heart rate, this is your highest heart rate recorded during the 10-minute test. Most likely this will occur during the final 2 minutes when you are using maximum intensity. Record your maximum heart rate or have your training partner record your maximum heart rate. And then calculating your VO2 max, you want to divide your maximum heart rate by your resting heart rate and then multiply that number by 15.3. That is your VO2 max score. You can use the chart that I have listed in the description box to determine strength of your score. The higher your score, the better. As you can see in the description box, there are two tables, one for men of ages 13 all the way up to above 60, and another table for women starting at age 13 and above the age of 60, and they are broken down by ages. You can see that for the men and for the women. There's an age category for age 13 through 19, another one for 20 through 29, 30 through 39, 40 through 49, 50 through 59, and 60 plus. So you can use these charts after you have calculated your VO2 max to determine if your scores are very poor, poor, fair, good, excellent, and superior. Again, the higher the VO2 max, the better. Thank you everybody for watching today's episode of Dr. Ozello Sports Medicine Report. I know I did things a little bit differently going over the VO2 max self-test. Please be careful when performing this test, and please see a medical professional before performing this test to make sure you are healthy enough for this test. You can see a doctor of chiropractic like myself, or you can see another type of medical professional. Please be safe. I am Dr. Donald Ozello of Championship Chiropractic in Las Vegas, Nevada. I am the author of Running, Maximize Performance and Minimize Injuries. You can visit my website, championshipchiropractic.com, where you can get additional information on the book, and you could find my blog. My blog contains articles on spine health, chiropractic care, sports medicine, health, fitness, and nutrition. So please visit my website, championshipchiropractic.com. Thank you very much for watching today's video. Please feel free to like this video. If you have questions, suggestions, or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. Please subscribe to my YouTube page, and always remember to train hard, but train smart. Get adequate rest between your training sessions. Utilize nutritional and supplementation strategies that work for you. Stay injury-free, rehabilitate all injuries, and accomplish your goals.